In this video, I'm going to give you a quick primer and explain the Dockerfile that we have used so far. On the left-hand side, you see the Dockerfile with all these instructions. On the right-hand side is the explanation. Right from what is Dockerfile? Dockerfile, again, is a text configuration which you can share, you can recreate, you can, since you have revision controlled it as Git, it's Git, you can also have this shared and automatically built the same image. Now, these are the main instructions, and we're going to look at the instructions on the left-hand side and try to understand what each of these do. Starting with from. Now, from is where we define which base image that we want to use to launch a container to build this image from. And that accepts all the four fields that an image can take. Right now, it is just a repository, but you can also provide tag, registry, as well as the namespace. The next is a run command. Run is a core of Dockerfile, and this is where we define what to do. So if you remember, I installed these applications manually earlier. In this case, Docker build automatically launches a build container. Inside that, it is going to run all these instructions, including apt-get update, install, etc. So layering is another important concept that you need to understand. And each of this instruction, almost everything except for from, is going to convert into a layer. So if you look at the layers using Docker image history, you will find out that it has about 6 layers created for that image, and that corresponds to the number of instructions that I have. So if you look at this, it's each instruction which is converting into a layer, except for from. I have 6 instructions, and each of that 6 instruction is converted into a layer. Now, there is a limit on the number of layers, so you need to be aware of how to optimize these layers and combine those run instructions using either and or using semicolons. Command is something that you define which needs to be launched at the runtime. After you create an image, and when you run an application or container using that image, what application to launch, that is the command. So you don't have to go and specify bin Facebook every time. It would automatically use that command because it's been provided as part of that image build instruction, which sets the metadata. That's command. Port is the application port that you want to expose on. And when you use capital P, it automatically reads the port that you have exposed, that is 16,000, and maps it to an available unused port. In this case, it's 32773. So that port mapping depends on what you put in expose instruction right here. You can also provide environment variables, add the files or copy it. Add and copy are quite similar. We are using copy here. So copy will copy from the build context. Build context is the current directory. So when you use Docker build command, whatever you provided as a build context at the end, in this case, it's current directory. All of this gets copied to the containers opt Facebook to build it, and then you run make all instructions, expose, and so on and so forth. There's also a concept of work directory, so everything that you do in the build container runs from the work directory. In fact, even if you launch a container and connect to that, you will land up in the work directory that serves as a present working directory for every single instruction, including command, run, build, everything. So it's opt Facebook is what I landed inside, and from here I have run that bin Facebook runs from that work directory. So everything runs with respect to the work directory. That was a very quick dive into the Dockerfile, mainly to explain the Dockerfile that we have used in the previous lesson to generate the image.